The consistent snow we've been having, the variation in temperatures, and then sub-zero cold snaps have meant trouble for homeowners. Ice dams and roof problems are sending some people scrambling for ways to prevent leaks and protect their houses. News 8's Keith Baldy is live tonight in Portland with more on that. Keith?
Well, Tracy, check this out. This is pretty typical for buildings here in Maine. You can see the icicles hanging off, and then there's ice that goes a few inches up the roof. Now, that's indicative a lot of times of heat loss from a building, but it also means potential water damage.
It's wintertime in Maine, and that means snow and ice, which can sometimes be pretty to look at. That's at least what Charity West Maryville thought at first when she noticed the icicles on the back of her home. Her opinion quickly changed.
I was actually at the stove cooking, and I started to feel these drips sort of splattering, and I thought, well, it's not what I'm making. So I looked up, and sure enough, I have a split seam.
Ice that built up on a roof caused water to back up and drip down between an old and new part of her house.
Yeah, frustrating, because now I have to replace all of this, because that's going to mold, and it's also financially a huge impact.
It's an expense that Travis DiRenzo tries to help homeowners avoid by clearing snow and ice as it builds throughout the season.
It's important to get the snow off from the peak all the way down, not just a little ways up. And then you bring it all down and you spread the calcium chloride and the dam breaks.
Something DiRenzo says his business, Snow Patrol 207, has been busy doing this year. He expects it to be even busier after this week's predicted snowstorm. In most cases, ice dams are caused by under-insulated homes that release heat through the top, causing snow to melt, then refreeze at the roof's edge. To get rid of the dams before they cause water backups and leaks, some, like DiRenzo, use environmentally safe snow melt. Others steam it away, and some will chip it. Although, unless you're an expert, doing that can create even more of a headache.
Getting up there with a hammer actually can potentially break the shingles loose. The ice is actually frozen right to the shingle. And what will happen is if you chip or pry on it, you can actually remove the shingle.
Now, another suggestion is to use heat tape that goes on the edge of your roof and then will melt the ice when you plug it in. But a lot of experts say if you better insulate your attic, that should get rid of a lot of these problems. We're live in Portland. Keith Baldy, News 8.